ओके, इन यूनिट नंबर सिक्स द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज कम्युनिकेशन आर्किटेक्चर. ओके, देन कम्युनिकेशन आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ द स्मार्ट ग्रिड इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ थ्री पैरामीटर, दैट इज जनरेशन, ट्रांसमिशन एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. ओके, देन ऑल्सो इन विच वी हैव टू यूज पावर जनरेशन एंड ट्रांसमिशन कैन बी कंट्रोल विद द हेल्प ऑफ वायरलेस एरिया नेटवर्क. ओके, एंड देन ट्रांसमिशन एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ओके कैन बी कंट्रोल विद द हेल्प ऑफ नेबरहुड एरिया नेटवर्क. ओके, दैट मीन्स दीज आर द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट नेटवर्क यूज इन कम्युनिकेशन. देन ऑल्सो डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड एंड यूजर कैन बी कंट्रोल विद द हेल्प ऑफ होम एरिया नेटवर्क. दैट मीन्स दिस इज द कम्युनिकेशन आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ द स्मार्ट ग्रिड. इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ थ्री नेटवर्क, दैट इज वैन, नैन एंड हेड, दैट इज वायरलेस एरिया नेटवर्क, देन नेबरहुड एरिया नेटवर्क एंड होम एरिया नेटवर्क. देन दैट मीन्स दीज आर द थ्री लेयर्स ऑफ द कम्युनिकेशन नेटवर्क एंड दिस थ्री लेयर यूज इन स्मार्ट ग्रिड. दिस इज द जस्ट ओवरव्यू ऑफ द कम्युनिकेशन इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज मल्टी लेयर स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द स्मार्ट ग्रिड. ओके, देन दिस कम्युनिकेशन आर्किटेक्चर विल बी यूज इन लार्ज जियोग्राफिकल एरिया. ओके, देन ऑल्सो इन विच वी हैव टू नीड कंट्रोल सेंटर एंड दिस कंट्रोल सेंटर कैन बी कंट्रोल विद द हेल्प ऑफ वायरलेस एरिया नेटवर्क. ओके, देन ऑल्सो इन विच वी हैव टू नीड द थ्री लेयर स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द कम्युनिकेशन नेटवर्क विल बी प्रोवाइड पोटेंशियल ऑपरेशन ऑफ द स्मार्ट ग्रिड. ओके, नाउ दिस थ्री लेयर स्ट्रक्चर इट गिव्स बेटर एफिशिएंसी देन मोर रिलायबल ऑपरेशन एंड सिक्योर ऑपरेशन. ओके, दैट मीन्स इट गिव्स बेटर एफिशिएंसी इन मल्टीलेयर स्ट्रक्चर इन स्मार्ट ग्रिड. ओके, देन ऑल्सो इन कंट्रोल सेंटर वी हैव टू नीड ट्रिमेंडस डेटा फ्रॉम एंड यूजर टू जनरेशन एंड ऑल डेटा कैन बी वेरीफाई विद द हेल्प ऑफ कंट्रोल सेंटर. ओके, दैट मीन्स ईच एंड एवरी नेटवर्क विल बी डिपेंड ऑन ईच टू ईच एवरी टू ईच अदर. दैट मीन्स दिस आर द ऑल नेटवर्क विल बी डिपेंड टू ईच अदर. दैट मीन्स वैन इज डिपेंड्स ऑन NAN, then NAN always depends on home area network. Okay, now these are the multiple structure of the smart grid. Also, smart grid is the integration of renewable energy sources. That means smart grid is always depends on renewable energy sources like solar energy, wind energy. Also, in which we have to need neighborhood area network because neighborhood area network is depends on two main power sources. Okay, and that means two main of the power sources mean power from utility side and power from distributed renewable energy side. These two power sources will be very important in multi-layer structure of the smart grid because it gives balancing of the different energy sources is very important in multi-layer structure of the smart grid. Okay, then also in which we have to need stability, then also need operation cost is very important in communication of the smart grid. Okay, also in which data will be flow from generation, transmission and distribution network with the help of user network. Also in which we have to use different techniques for the communication and these techniques will be depends on their parameters like generation, distribution and transmission. Okay, then also in which we have to need two-way communication between sending end and receiving end with the help of control center. That means amount of data will be transferred to the generation to transmission and transmission to distribution. And also control central control generation and only distribution. Okay. Then also in which tremendous data will be present from generation side to distribution side. Okay. Then this amount of data will be varies continuously, and at that instant we have to need data communication required for smart grid, because it gives more reliable operation of the system. That means first, reliability is very important in communication of the smart grid. Okay. Then also in which use the smart grid will be depends on computer network. Okay. Because computer network easy to control all the parameters of the smart grid. Okay. Now this is the multilayer structure, just overview of the multilayer structure of the smart grid when using communication technology. Okay. Now this is just overview of the communication technology useful for smart grid. Okay. Then also in which first parameter is wide area measurement system. Okay. Then also wide area measurement system also depends on communication technology, and this concept is developed or discovered by Taylor in 2006. And also the wide area measurement system, it consists of number of peoples, number of operating conditions, also in which we have to need sharing arrangement of the data is very important. That means wide area measurement system, it easy to deliver useful information to the control center. Also wide area measurement system will be depends on phase measurement unit. That means phase measurement units will be used, and this PME measurement also applicable or also used in power system. And also PME, it gives high speed and low cost communication system. That means phase measurement unit used in power system, and this phase measurement unit will be depends on communication system. Okay. Then also wide area measurement system will be depends on synchro phaser, and it gives conventional measurement. That means all parameter will be easy to measure with the help of PMU, and this PMU will be send information to the control center. Also wide area measurement system also depends on geographical area and easy to operate, control and protect power system with the help of wide area measurement system. Also in wide area measurement system will be depends on different process. Okay. That means sending all data, also verify all data and send to the control center. Okay. Then in wide area measurement system is depends on communication system. That means in which data and applications is very important in wide area measurement system. Now this total process used in power system. Okay. Now this is the just overview of the wide area measurement system. That means this is applicable only power system and easy to access all parameters of the power system from generation side to distribution side with the help of wide area measurement system. That means wide area measurement system is depends on communication infrastructure. That means two-way communication is very important in wide area measurement system. Then home area network. That is home area network is the important type of the energy management system. and also home area network connect to the all smart meter and also connected to the intelligent electronic devices. Okay, then home area network like Wi-Fi, Zigbee, Bluetooth. Okay, now these are the home area network, and this home area network will be connected to the other meters, then smart thermostat. Also, home area network is connected to the wind energy, solar energy, then energy storage, battery, then smart appliances, then plug hybrid electric vehicles, then electric vehicles. Okay, also connected to the Zigbee or PLC. Then also use smart meter, and this smart meter is connected with the help of wireless communication to the grid. That means smart meter always used in your home. Okay, that means this is the concept of home area network. Okay, now this is a just overview of the home area network. Okay, then also home area network also consists of smart meters, then television, then laptop, then mobiles. Also use air conditioner, then smart appliances, that is washing machine. These all the parameter can be controlled with the help of Wi-Fi. Okay, that is the Wi-Fi is the best example of home area network. Okay, then also in your home the mobile phone can be used, and this mobile phone control all the smart appliances in your home with the help of home security system. Okay, because in which use program, and this Wi-Fi program, and this Wi-Fi program control all the parameters with the help of Wi-Fi frequency. Now this is the just concept of home area network. That means all appliances in your home will be controlled with the help of mobile phone, that is infraradiations or Wi-Fi connectivity, also Bluetooth connectivity. Also the home area network, its value in smart grid, because it gives better efficiency, also easy to control all parameters with the help of Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. Okay, now this is the these are the wireless solution, that is Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. It require low power, and its network is very simple. Okay, that means also its communication range is 10 to 100 meters, and their require low power is 1 to 100 megawatt, and its cost is very less. Now this is the home area network value in smart grid. And also home area network will be depends on demand side management. Okay, and demand side management also include efficiency and demand response. Now this is just overview of the home area network in smart grid. Also in which we need their communication range and their power requirement. Okay, then next point is neighborhood area network. Okay, the neighborhood area network will be depends on bandwidth, and also neighborhood area network in which we have to need two-way communication. Okay, and also this two-way communication will be depends on meter reading, then demand response. Also neighborhood area network also used in homes and businesses. Okay, then also neighborhood area network will be controlled with the help of radio technology. Okay, then it gives excellent propagation in radio frequency, and its maximum range is 900 megahertz. And also neighborhood area network can be controlled with the help of mesh network. Okay, then also neighborhood area network can be controlled with the help of PLC, that is program logical controller. Also use RF system, that is radio frequency system. Okay, then also neighborhood area network will be depends on WiMAX communication system. And this Wi-Fi or WiMAX communication system depends on framework. And also WiMAX framework using smart grid for better communication. Also neighborhood area network can be controlled with the help of internet technology. Okay. Also neighborhood area network also using distribution system for control center. Okay, now this is the concept of neighborhood area network. Okay, now also in neighborhood area network, the range is 10 to 100 kb per second and its frequency is 900 megahertz. Then home area network range is 1 to 10 kb per second. Okay, then it's operate on communication technology like Zigbee. Okay, now home area network, its frequency is less than neighborhood area network because neighborhood area network frequency is 10 to 100 kb per second and home area network is 1 to 10 kb per second. Now this is the exact difference between home area network and neighborhood area network. Okay, now this is just overview of the neighborhood area network. Now this is the smart grid network structure. Okay, also in which difference between wide area management system. Okay, then also in which we have to use advanced metering infrastructure, and also in which difference between WAN and NAN, that is wide area network system and neighborhood area network system. Okay, also in which home area network use, then building area network use, then industrial area network. Now this is the building area network, this is the industrial area network, and this is the home area network. Okay, now this is the generation side. Okay, this is the generator side, this is the transmission side, this is the distribution side, this is the utility control center, and all parameter can be controlled with the help of wide area network. And also this is the collector access point, and this collector access point is connected with the help of neighborhood area network. That means this is the home area network, this is the building area network, and this is the industrial area network. Okay, now this is just overview of the